Friends, today I'm going to show you how to make a 3D printable fridge magnet, so let's get cracking. We are going to be building with Tinkercad. Make sure you visit tinkercad.com, choose sign in with Google, and today we're going to create a new 3D design. I like to always start with the name. Name it Fridge Magnet, and I'm going to put V2 because I've done this once or twice. As we get going, I do want to thank Brent for the idea. Let me show you how we're going to build this. We're going to type parameters. I'll show you why in a second. We're going to do a radius of 3, keep the steps at 10. We're going to make this 40 and 40. And we're going to make the height 8. So real quickly, you can see this basic shape is what we built our fridge magnet out of. We are going to have two of these. We're going to cut designs in. And then one of my favorite things, I'm going to hit T for transparent. We are going to add a pin that prints in place and then once finished, allows us to open our fridge magnet and see a message that's inside. So we need to stand this up for 3D printing. This makes the pin work the way that I want. We're going to do that by using this handle right here. Notice if you stay inside the shape, it goes 22.5 degrees at a time. If you hold shift, it is 45 degrees at a time. Once we hit 90, you can click D to drop it to the work plane. We need a second one. Let's do control D. Now for a print in place project, we need to really be careful with our measurements. So we're going to bring out a ruler. When we click on our shape, notice I got it close enough that it's 0 at the corner. I'm going to make sure that I've got both of these selected, and I want it to also be 0 here. So it is nudged to the exact 0, 0 location. It also shows us our design is 8 millimeters by 40. I'm going to click somewhere else and just click on the second one, and I'm going to use the arrow keys to nudge this out until the distance apart is 9. Notice it still shows me our shape is 8 by 40, but now we have got a gap of 1 millimeter in between, which we double checked with the ruler. I will show you quickly, if you hit use midpoint, it changes your measurement. So if your numbers are different than mine, make sure that you're using endpoint for that part of the project. Now we can dismiss the ruler and move to the next step. Control D. I'm going to shift nudge to move this one out. And once again, we're going to type the numbers. I'm going to tell you the numbers we want to use are 8, 15, and 16. Notice we kept the radius of 3 and the steps of 10. That'll stay the same throughout the project. It's what helps this so that it moves the way we want. We're also going to hit D to drop it to the bottom. We're going to line this up with this piece back here. Do shift select to grab the two, choose L for a line, make this one the boss, and we want it to come to the back edge. And then we're going to look at it from a corner. I love using the view cube so it's easier to see. And we're going to make sure it's in the center, which it was. Now we can spin back around, and we're going to hide this one for a moment. And we want to move it 1 millimeter forward, just like that. We're going to take these two at this moment and do control G to group them. They're going to be the back of our magnet. Let's quickly do show all to bring back our other parts. And let's create the cutout. Once again, we're going to do control D. I'll do shift nudge so you can move it out and see it. This is going to be a hole. And we must type the numbers again. It's 12, 16. And then we want a little extra gap. So this is going to be 10. Once you press enter, it'll snap into place. And we can do D to drop. We are going to shift select these two parts, do L for a line, click on the red one, and we want to center it, and then click on it, and I want you to do control down arrow twice. Now let's use shift select to grab the two and do control G to group them. Our base shapes are complete. It's time to build our rotation mechanism. We're going to do that with a cylinder. When you bring it out, set the sides all the way to the max, and we're going to shrink it to a special size. We want it to be 5 millimeters on a side, so what I tell you to do is hold shift, stretch it a little bit, click the box, type 5, and press enter. We're going to make the length of it 32, so I'm just stretching it out and typing 32 and pressing enter. Of course, we need to rotate it. I'm going to do it by holding shift. Remember, it's 22 and a half degrees. If you don't hold shift, if you do hold shift and stay inside that large circle, it's super easy to flip it just like that. Right now, I'm going to hit D to drop. We're going to align this with the parts that we have here. So right now, I'm going to do shift select. I want to click L for align, make this one the boss, and I want it to come to the center and the center. When we let go, you'll notice that height is not correct. Well, we're going to fix that with this one. First, we need to ungroup it. Then we're going to shift select those two pieces and do an L for align. Make this one the boss, and we want to center it vertically. Bingo, we've got that in the exact center. And once again, it's 5 millimeters on a side. We're going to use this a second time, so do Control D. Make it a solid. I'm going to just go with the orange, and I'm going to lock it. That way it stays in place, even though I'm going to select these other two. Notice I've got the hole. If you have to click twice, you can do that. And then I'm going to shift select this large one and do Control G to group. If we hit T for transparent, right now the orange one's in the way, but if we hide it, you can see we have just cut out where the pin is going to go. I'm going to click Show All to bring all those parts back. All right, friends, let me show you how we make the pins. We're going to click on this one. We're going to unlock it. We're going to take what was 32, and we're going to make it 16. We did that because this piece right here is 15. So if we shift select the two, do L for align, make the red one the boss, and choose middle, we've got these orange ends sticking out for attaching and aligning our little cones. We're going to hide this one. We're going to grab a cone, and we're going to cruise it on the end of that shape. We're going to simply type in parameters again. We want our top radius to be 1.8 and press enter. We want our base radius to be 2.2. Note these are less than the 5 that we had before. And we're going to take the height, and we're going to change it to 10. I'm going to leave the sides at 24. I'm going to put the exact same one on the other side. We're going to do that by doing Control D. Shift nudge to get it to the other side, and then we're just going to mirror it. Now we're going to hit W for work plane, click where we want to put it, and do D to drop. I am going to put the work plane back on the base, and let's shift select those three items. Choose L for align, make sure we pick the orange one, and we want him to be centered this way and this way. Now that we've got those lined up, we can hit Show All. And then we're going to bring these back so they don't bump into that edge. Notice I'm just using the arrow keys, and there are 3 clicks. I'm going to nudge it back. Notice I'm just making sure it is not running into that edge anymore. And then we can click on this orange one, and we can make it shorter so that it's hiding inside. It's still handy to have if we ever want to align anything. I'm going to just simply set it to 12. And I'm going to shift-click the red one, do L for align, make the red the boss, and choose the middle. So it's still there, but it's not in the way. And now it's easy for you to see those gaps for our pin. Let's hide this again quickly and select all of this and do Control-G to group. And let's do Show All to bring it back. Friends, right there is your print-in-place magnet. Notice there are gaps all the way around, so as soon as you're done, it will be able to flip up and down. At this point, friends, it's time to add the spot for your magnet. You need to measure your own magnets. I doubt you have the exact same one I have. Because I am not worried about rounding the edges of this with the radius, I stretched my handles. I needed 25.5, 19, and then I chose a thickness of 4.7. So whatever you have, whether it's a circle or a rectangle or whatever magnet, pick the measurements that fit it. Then you can shift select, do L for align, pick the part that it attaches to, and we want to put it in the back. I'm going to look at this one from the corner because we want that center dot. Notice that's out front. And now that part is aligned. I can grab those two shapes and I can simply group them. So after it prints, I'll be able to stick the magnet in there. Of course, you can use a little bit of glue to hold it permanently in place. As far as decorations, first I'm going to hit T so that it's not transparent anymore. And we just need to set them on top. and then I chose to cut them in. You can add words or images. Notice you could bring this text out, make it a hole, and cut it in. You can also go to a tool like Canva and get fancy text or images. Let me show you that technique super quick. When I visit Canva, I use Sign In with Google. I like to work on the Instagram square post, and then I like to add text. I like to add a text box, pick my word. For this one today, I'm going to put my channel name. If I do Control A, I can grab those words and type HLModTech. Once again, you can put whatever words or pictures you want using this same type of technique. When you click over here, there are tons of fonts. Find one that you think is awesome. You can adjust the spacing of it. You can make the letters connect, spread out, whatever you think is going to look fantastic. I'm going to also add a fun effect to this today. I'm going to make it so that it curves. Once again, you can use the little handles to get it to the exact spot you want. I think that is going to be awesome. Now I'm going to make it just a little bit larger. Maybe adjust that spacing between the letters just a tiny bit. And when I'm happy, I'm going to screen capture this design. I've got a shortcut that lets me just do that in one quick click. This takes me to Snagit. Of course, whatever screen capture tool you use, you can simply save that as an image, like a PNG, so we can use it for the next step. Once you have that image, we're going to use Pick SVG to make it an SVG file. Simply upload the picture. There is my HLMT. I'm going to open it. I do not want these edges. Instead, I want the internal, so it's all one color, and we can download that SVG. I'm going to put mine in my downloads folder, and I'm going to just use that silly name because I doubt I need this again. Finally, with that done, we are back in Tinkercad, and we can import that file we just created. In my downloads, a simple click and open. I want art. I know my whole project's 40 by 40, so instead of this 256, I'm going to type 35. Notice they both scale, and I'm going to choose import. It does take a moment, but bingo, there is my text. I do want to put it up on the shape. We're going to use C for cruising to do that, and I can cruise it right up there. And then I want you to understand that this is the wrong way. We need to rotate it 180 degrees because it's going to flip from the other direction. I do want to align it, so I'm going to shift select, do L for align. Make this one the boss, and I want him to choose middle and middle. Although note that doesn't line up perfect, I'm going to put the work plane up here so I can click on this, and then my arrow keys move the way that I expect. I'm going to make that a hole. You can bump up the quality if you want, and then I'm going to do control down arrow to sink that in 2 millimeters. That's how much I chose to cut mine in. You can adjust that if you want. I can now shift select those two pieces and do control G to group. HLModTech is now on the front of my magnet. I'm going to quickly hide that, and we're going to put the words for the inside as well. Instead of custom text, I'm going to show you the normal text, and I'm going to type, let's get cracking. Notice I do have to do it in three pieces, but there's my let's. I am going to flip this right now so it's the right way. If I zoom in, there's my rotation handle. I can move this across, and let's do Control D and a few arrows and get, and Control D again and a few arrows, or shift nudge, and let's put Kraken. I'm going to press W for work plane to make sure it's on that piece. Do D for drop for all of those. They did land where they were supposed to, so now I can just move them into place. I can just squeeze until I've got the sizes I want and the location I want. I am going to, of course, make them all holes. So shift select hole. Let's do control down arrow to drop them in. And I'm going to do one last align to make sure they're all in the middle. L for align. Make this one the master, and bingo, there is my let's get cracking. Feel like one more arrow there is dandy. We've got the magnet hole. Let's select all of those and do control G to group. Haha, let's get cracking. And then on the outside, there's an HLModTech. Friends, I'm gonna put the work plane back down on the ground, double check all those gaps. Once again, make sure you hit T for transparent. Make sure there is room around every edge of that. And when you're happy, make sure you get it approved by your teacher and you're ready to send it to the 3D printer. It's as simple as selecting it all and choosing export, only the selected shapes, and an STL. I always save mine to my 3D modeling folder, so now we can simply hit save. Now we can bounce to Bambu Studio. I'm gonna create a brand new project. We can bring in that file, and just like that, it is ready to print. Now, if you wanted to make this multicolor, you could, but it would greatly increase the print time. I'm gonna print mine at the fastest draft. Let's slice that plate, and let's print that plate. Notice it's gonna be done in less than 30 minutes. Of course, once we hit send, soon it moves to the device menu, and when it finishes downloading, we can click the play button and monitor everything from afar. 30 minutes later, there's our print. And of course, boom, let's get cracking. How cool is that? Friends, just a reminder, if you want me or anybody else to see your awesome project, you can publish it super quick by simply going back to the Tinkercad desktop and click on the tiny gear and choose properties. Of course, give it a name, give it a description. Mine will mention that the tutorial is coming soon. Of course, there are links you can find my other stuff. Remember, you simply copy these and paste them in your browser to get there. I do also want to highlight the tag HLMT23. Friends, if you add that to any project, I check it almost every day, and of course, I will give you a reaction. Next, make your design public. And then I like to choose attribution, no derivatives. That means people can see your projects, but they cannot copy them. Finally, hit save changes. That makes your project go to the gallery. Notice the gallery initially shows staff pics. These are always awesome. Make sure you check them out and make sure you give a reaction for their creation, CMF. That is fantastic. What I love to do though is shut off those staff pics. Click the little button so we can see more designs at once and check out all the amazing designs created by other users. Whenever you see them, don't forget you can click on them and give them a reaction. ZDP, that's fantastic. Real quickly though, let's check out the HLMT23 tag. Once again, if you type that and press enter, the first thing you'll see are all of the items sorted by relevance. I instead want to sort by recent. Friends, I do want to highlight, it is awesome to have all of these users sharing awesome projects with me. It is a fantastic place for you to get inspired and learn about other tinkerers. I do want to quickly highlight though, I appreciate when it's used for designs instead of notes. If users would take a moment to remove the tag from those sort of projects, that would be fantastic. Friends, as I wrap up, of course, I want to say thanks to Brent once again for starting me on this project idea. I also want to thank everybody that's supporting me on Patreon. It absolutely makes my day to see how that community is growing. You can find out more by checking the links in the description. Finally, I want to thank you for watching the video. Remember, every time you click that like button, share a video, add a comment, or hit subscribe, you're helping this channel get a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Of course, friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.